and welcome everybody to the 84th annual Concord Christmas Parade presented by ACN. I'm Suzanne Howard, and with me is my dear, dear friend Teresa Padgett. And we have in front of us performing around here the Sheriff's Department Motorcycle Unit, doing a little back and forth and tricks and turns and things on their motorcycles.
Next year we ought to ride on one of the motorcycles.
Okay.
Now we could try.
Can I get a fancy helmet? Maybe put the tiara on the helmet. That'll work.
Well, we wouldn't have to worry about our hair.
No, helmet head is not attractive at all. So.
Next, we've got the Joint Honor Guard of Concord Fire and Life Safety and Harrisburg Fire. The Honor Guard is Ed Shaver, who's the commander, Robbie Troutman, captain, Ron Blackwelder, and Harrisburg Fire Department, Russ Freeze. Thank you guys for being our honor guard today.
And we have Chief Holloway of Concord Fire and Life Safety. And he's got his beautiful family in there with him.
Merry Christmas. Next we have the Concord Police Chief, Guy Smith, and I believe he has some of his family in there with him also. Merry Christmas, Chief.
Now that's a new logo on those police cars.
Yes,
isn't
these
it?
Are new cars, and they are so. The police are so excited to have them.
They are beautiful, very different. Like them. And of course, no parade would be complete without Sheriff Brad Riley and his beautiful wife.
Merry Christmas. Next, we have represented the Kannapolis Police Department, and in their vehicle, they have Brent Rowland and Brandon Worrell. Welcome to the Kannapolis Police Department.
And I think Kannapolis has got some new cars, too. Yeah. Looking good.
Merry Christmas.
And we have an entry from the North Carolina Highway Patrol. This is Trooper Malcolm Eason. Welcome. So glad you could make it.
Next we have our Crime Stopper car, and Sergeant Brandon Johnson is driving that, and it looks like he has some members of his family in there also.
And of course the Concord Parade banner is really the very start, 84th Annual Concord Christmas Parade, and is presented by ACN this year, actually again this year. They've been our sponsors the last couple of years. And we've got a beautiful float the night before Christmas. Some of their employees, I think, riding on the float.
Hi, Merry Christmas.
You know, they're one of the world's largest direct sellers of communications, and they are so active in the community.
Yes, we were very fortunate to have them sponsor the parade and a lot of other things.
And their employees regularly volunteer at the Ronald McDonald House.
Then that's a very worthy cause. Next, we've got a 1963 Seagraves fire engine, and on it is the Concord City Council. All the members of the council are on there, and there's Miss Ella May in the inside.
Yeah, Ella May is the smart one. She's inside,
yes,
warm.
She's staying warm. And City Council and Mayor Scott Padgett.
So you know him?
Well, pretty well. We're going on 30 years now.
We have a great council in place right now. We really do. Concord's very lucky to have these gentlemen and ladies that dedicate their time and service to the community.
And they certainly do. And if you've never been to the tree lighting fireworks, which is always the night before the parade, I would strongly suggest you go. It's exciting. And they make sure that happens every year. We got a pretty car coming up here.
Now this is our Grand Marshal. CMC Northeast is celebrating 75 years, and riding in this beautiful car is Phyllis Wingett, the president of CMC Northeast, and Nancy Burridge, their oldest employee. Now, I heard a tale about Nancy delivering babies in the cars. They were drive-up babies. You drive up, and Nancy would run out and deliver.
Well, that's pretty amazing. And didn't you tell me a little something else that would happen with some of the doctors were on the golf course?
I did. When the golf course was still around the hospital, Nancy would hang bed sheets out the windows to let the doctors know they better come in because the women were ready to deliver.
That's a great story.
Well, I know CMC is proud to celebrate their 75th anniversary, and that means they opened their doors on July 26, 1937.
Wow. Here comes another nice old car, and I believe we have Dr. Bob Hammonds, retired physician, and Dr. Bob Kinney, Vice President of Education and Research Chair for CMC Northeast Advisory Board. And CMC Northeast wishes you and yours a happy and healthy holiday. Merry Christmas.
Now, I see one of our favorites, Teresa. This is Wellaby High Banks. And Wellaby's riding on the float with some of their friends from the Jeff Gordon Hospital.
Merry Christmas.
And this is one of three units. This is one unit for the Carolinas Medical Northeast Mobile Intensive Care unit. They respond to neonatal, pediatric, adult critically ill, and injured parents between hospital facilities. They work closely with the Jeff Gordon's Children's Hospital. And they've already made over 1,000 trips this year. So they're a vital part of the transport service.
They certainly are. Next, we have the CMC Northeast Mobile Mammogram Coach. And they are proud to participate in the Concord Christmas Parade. Mammograms are the best screening tool available to detect breast cancer at its earliest, most treatable ages. And as we all know, Suzanne, that's very important to do that yearly.
That is. And we have the Northwest Cabarrus High School, Air Force Junior ROTC. The program is headed up by retired Lieutenant Colonel Calvin Martin and retired Senior Master Sergeant Corrine Smith.
What a nice looking group of young men and women.
There are over 100 cadets performing many community activities such as visits to nursing homes and assisted living facilities, presenting the colors at sporting events and graduation ceremonies. The mission of the Air Force Junior ROTC is to develop citizens of character dedicated to serving their nation and community. Very proud bunch of young men and women there.
And I think, Suzanne, we may be seeing our first beauty queen in the parade. And this is Miss Gridiron, Brittany Wood. She was selected as Northwest Cabarrus 2012 Homecoming Queen. Congratulations, Brittany.
And she is a beautiful young lady.
She certainly is. I know we'll have a lot more beauty queens to come, but it's nice to have our first one. And I'm sure they had to think about what they wore today with this wind.
I don't think there are going to be many strapless sequins gowns. I think they'll all be bundled up.
Yeah, even though those cars are going slow, this wind, it will be chilly.
now believe we have the Northwest Cabarrus High School cheerleaders coming.
Certainly excited and having a great time.
And that's one cheer that'll get you in the spirit right there.
Exactly.
Keep that Christmas spirit up.
And they've been walking a long while doing
this,
so that's good. And I think I hear a band. It's a little ways off. It's coming down the road, though, and I believe it'll be our first band.
It will. A couple things while we've got a second to point out. Paramount Catering and Speakeasy Ale House, of course, are sponsoring our VIP tent. And we have some firefighters over there who were instrumental in helping a family that was burned out and getting some clothing and things together for that family. So we welcome you and we thank you for the service that you do and putting your life on the line every day. We also have a beautiful, beautiful arrangement for our judges on the judges stand over here from Midway Florist, and it is absolutely gorgeous. They're going to be in the parade this year, first time.
Fantastic.
So
I noticed that arrangement, but I didn't know where it came from. That is great. And as I said, I think I hear our first band coming up. And this is the Northwest Cabarrus Marching Band. It says earned numerous first place and superior awards over the past several years. And I would say let's just listen to them.
The band, and this is the Northwest Cabarrus High School Leadership Group.
Merry Christmas.
They're dreaming of a neon Christmas, and I know why. Man, y'all are bright. Bright and happy. They designed their float after the homecoming success of Totally 80s, Nothing But Neon.
Next we have the FFA chapter. Christmas Carol. This float will show different occupations of FFA jobs or agriculture jobs. And they've got a great float. I see all different kinds of occupations there. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. We have Liz Poole, Pam Dubois, our Deputy County Manager, and of course Commissioner-elect Steve Morris. Our local leaders are representing Cabarrus County today.
Next we have Griffin Brothers Tires, Wheel and Automotive Service in Concord. Welcome.
And we have Covenant Classical School. The mission of Covenant Classic is to provide an education of excellence. And they have grades K-4 through 12. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas. They certainly still have a lot of energy for towards the end of the parade.
They do. And I'm sure they've warmed up with that long march down here. So, and Teresa, it's a beautiful afternoon. We've got a great crowd. As I'm looking down the street, I see them 2, 3, 4, in some places 5 deep. So we are thrilled that so many citizens of Concord and Cabarrus County have come out for the parade this afternoon.
And you mentioned Paramount Catering early doing the VIP tent. We are so fortunate to have another restaurant in downtown Concord. They've been open, I think, about 2 or 3 years now. But we always welcome all new additions to downtown Concord. So if you've not been there, you might want to stop in after the parade.
I'm sure they'll be busy.
I think they will. And also, the city of Concord does such a great job after the parade of getting Union Street cleaned up and Church Street very quickly so that people can get out.
They do, and I think we've got a shot right now of all
the crowd. Oh, yes, look at the crowd.
Everybody wave, you may be on camera.
Yeah, wave. Yes, that is a great crowd. Our next addition to our parade is the Cabarrus County Convention and Visitors Bureau. It's a destination marketing organization that promotes tourism and local spending in our wonderful county. They have been just a great addition to our area, and we are just so happy to see all of them in there. Merry Christmas!
They've got a little four-legged elf there.
Yep. And their motto is "Where Racing Lives." Ooh, what a pretty car.
Nothing like a pink Cadillac.
Whoa!
And these beautiful young ladies are with Stylistic Salon. We have the owner, Tammy Richards, and the stylists were Brandy Nelson, Glenda Owens, and Sylvia Bullware. And they're a family-friendly salon, so y'all be sure to stop by.
Do you think we could borrow that car after the parade?
I think we could get a ride.
Okay, next we have a banner from Cannon Pharmacy and also a vehicle. And they want to thank all of you for voting them number one. I believe they won in the Independent Tribune had a promotion, and they were number one.
They did.
So Cannon Pharmacy. And if I'm correct, they deliver, which is a great addition, if it's hard for you to get out to get your medicine. Oh, what a beautiful float they have.
Oh, it is beautiful.
Yes. Merry Christmas.
And it's cold enough to let it snow.
Yes, it is. And these are the cars that they deliver in that you see right behind the float. I see them going up and down the road making deliveries.
Yep.
Oh, Suzanne.
Well, Teresa, this is obviously our special celebrity guest. This is John Wilson. Has everybody heard of Wilson's World?
Everybody give him a big hand.
Now, Wilson is with his daughter, Chloe. Chloe, we're so excited to have you with us this afternoon. And they're being driven by none other than Gary Walter.
He's not Santa Claus.
No, he's not Santa.
Wilson,
thank you. Thank you for coming this afternoon. Chloe, stay warm. I heard that Wilson's favorite thing was a peanut butter milkshake and fried pickles.
Ooh. Okay.
And we have that beautiful entry from Midway Florist, owner Tina Steen, designers Beth Stillwell, Jennifer Childers, and Candace Stevens. And they have a slogan. We have a flower for that.
Oh,
I love
it.
That.
I love that. Okay, go ahead.
And we have Harvey and Owings Insurance Agency. Gail Harvey and Chris Owens, they have insurance from a Christian perspective to cover all your needs.
And Midway does do such a beautiful job. I have ordered some things from them in the past, and do a great job.
And again, they did that beautiful arrangement on the judges' stand for us.
Well, next we've got a big engine with a big horn, but this is Pack 888 from Concord, North Carolina. It's sponsored by Forest Hill United Methodist Church, and its meetings are held every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Flying the colors of the pirate, Henry Avery. Wow, what a great pack. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
And they've all got their red sweatshirts on.
I didn't know that pirates wore Santa hats.
That's a new one on me, too.
This is our entry from Northeast Fire Department in their 1999 Pierce Sabra, I think, fire engine. They have served the northeastern part of the Cabarrus County since 1975. We're so glad to have them. You know, later on we'll have several of our emergency vehicles from the different departments in the parade. We have Ashley Sanders, Miss Cabarrus County, and Sadia Richards, Miss Cabarrus County, Carolina Princess, excuse me. Two gorgeous girls. The sparkle from the tiara just took me away.
Well, Suzanne, as I can see up the road, we've got a lot of beauty queens and a lot of pretty tiaras and a lot of red. In this car, we have Megan Braun, Miss Cabarrus County Outstanding Teen 2013, and Ava Reese, Miss Cabarrus County Outstanding Teen Carolina Princess 2013. Very beautiful outfits.
And what beautiful young ladies, you know, not just physically, but they're very poised young ladies. They're beautiful inside and out. And in this car, we have Laura Mullis, Youth Majestic Miss Cabarrus County, Jillian Keith, Tiny Miss Cabarrus County, and Riley Hutchins, Baby Miss Cabarrus County. I wonder where they found the baby tiara. It's absolutely beautiful.
Next, we have Alana Cooper, Teen Miss Cabarrus County, Reeston Shell, Little Miss Cabarrus County, and Lily Beaver, Young Miss Cabarrus County. Merry Christmas to all of you.
And Teresa, this is Girl Scout Troop 1711 from Harrisburg, and walking today are their Brownies, Juniors, and Cadets.
Merry Christmas. As you and I have said, we were both Girl Scouts. Next, we have several entries from Less Dance Studio. First, we have a vehicle, and then we have the marching unit is composed of competition team dancers and pom-poms, which range in age from 7 to 18 years of age. And don't they look great in their purple?
They really do. And in the car today were Lynn's parents, Buddy and Betty Phillips.
So, okay.
They're helping out with the parade today.
And seven members of the team also danced in the All-Star Tap Team in the National Cherry Blossom Festival Parade held in Washington this past April.
Wow.
They are really active.
And each year this group holds a fundraiser in January for the Jeff Gordon's Children's Hospital. And currently they've raised over $12,000, so that's just a great, great job.
That is fantastic. And now we've got another float coming by with some more dancers from Less Dance Studio.
And they're very festive in their hats.
Don't they look nice?
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Oh, look at Snowman.
Well, I didn't know that that snowmen worked for could climb a tree, to tell you the truth. But
no,
this is
I'm not.
This is Carolina Tree Care, located here in Concord. They have a professional tree care company, tree removal, trimming, and plant health care. Well, welcome, Mr. Snowman, and hope you don't melt in that sunshine up there. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, I'm really interested to know how the snowman got up there.
That's why they have those bucket trucks.
You're right.
Listen, right up there.
Okay. And like you said, though, I bet it's a little warm up there.
Just hope they have drainage holes for the puddles. And
our next entry is all about storage. Is conveniently located on Wilshire Avenue in Concord, offering self-storage units, boat and RV parking, and office warehouse space. And they've decked their golf cart out really nice. Their office offers boxes, moving supplies, and U-Haul rental trucks.
It kind of looks like Rudolph.
Yes, it does. So welcome to All About Storage. Merry Christmas. See, once again, I just can't believe how beautiful it is today.
It is a gorgeous, gorgeous fall day. This novel Christmas entry is presented for our enjoyment by Daniel Clothing Warehouse, Dixie Cleaners, and Atkinson Eye Care.
Well, it looks like our ACN people in the VIP area are enjoying the parade and refreshments. And once again, we appreciate their help so much in sponsoring this parade.
And we can't forget the City of Concord. Good afternoon, Mayor.
Hello.
Sponsoring our band entries today. Yeah. We actually have 8 bands in this parade today.
Fantastic. So our next entry is Body in Balance Studio. Ooh, Suzanne. Affordable massage and skincare. Only $45 for a 1-hour massage.
Can you say gift certificate?
Yes.
They would fit right in the stocking.
And this is their everyday price, not a special. So $45 for 1 hour. Give them a hand. That sounds great to me. And they're located beside Jersey Mike's Sub, behind Captain's Galley on Copperfield Boulevard.
Teresa, we have the Air Force Junior ROTC from Central Cabarrus High School. It's the 51st Cadet Group, led by Cadet Colonel Jesse D. Garza, and the Deputy Commanders, Lieutenant Colonel Mariana Sabayan. I'm sorry if I mess up these names. And Cadet Commander, Chief Master Sergeant is David Stidham. They have 93 cadets, and they range in age from freshmen to seniors. And this cadet group is the oldest and largest Air Force Junior ROTC unit in Cabarrus County.
Wow, that is impressive. And once again, I mean, a lot of these young men and young women will go into the service and be protecting us in years to come.
That's right, and they do all kinds of community activities like Adopt a Highway. They have model rocketry that they do, flight simulators. They help with their Toys for Tots. So great young men and women.
I think what we have coming up next is Central Cabarrus High School. And our first entry is the homecoming queen, Miss Gabby Bingley. Gabby Bingley, congratulations and welcome. And she is the homecoming queen for Central Cabarrus.
So many lovely young ladies.
Oh, they are. They're beautiful. I'm glad they're wearing coats today, though, so that they can stay warm. Well, next coming up is the Central Cabarrus Marching Vikings. Okay. The director is Stephen Petrucci. I hope I pronounced that right. The assistant director, Drew Carter. The Central Cabarrus High School Marching Band has a rich history of excellence, being a multiple bands of America Grand National and a regional finalist. Don't these girls look great? I'm not sure if I could dance in a box. They've won many awards. Let's listen to them.
They sound wonderful. That'll put you in the spirit.
Oh, great.
And also we have the Central Cabarrus Step Team. It's a sport team that promotes spirits, and they support all of the athletes, and they're a community service driven. They support their school and various community organizations.
And of course, they're cheerleaders, Central Cabarrus cheerleaders.
Happy holidays, everyone. Yes. Teresa, we have Living Faith Church located on Rock Hill Church Road in Concord. And they would just like to encourage everyone to give thanks this holiday season and find a place of worship of your choice and count your blessings.
Great costumes.
Merry Christmas.
Now, this one has been in our parade for as long as I can remember, the Restoration Tabernacle bus. They have service times on Sunday at 9 and 11:30, and the pastors are Benjamin and Stephanie May. They are a multicultural, cross-denominational church, and they always have a nice bus, a nice vehicle in the parade. Well, Suzanne, have you started on your Christmas shopping?
Oh, no. No, I don't even have an inkling of what anybody wants or needs. So I've got to get busy, don't I?
Yes, you do. What about Wilson? Have you started on your Christmas shopping?
Hey, let me sneak up over here. Hey!
Hello, young man. Hey. How are you?
How y'all doing? Hello. Man, this is such a great parade. I just want to say thanks for having me. This was so much fun. I haven't been up here in a couple years for the parade. This was awesome. So big thanks, everybody. And so many people and so many cool kids smiling and all that good stuff.
Well, good. We're so glad you got to come.
Oh, we're so just we thrilled just you could come.
Well, it was great. Chloe had a great time. So big thanks, everybody. It was a lot of fun. I think we got another float coming in, guys.
Oh, yeah.
We do. And this is the Universal Healthcare Float.
Got it.
And it's another one of our professional floats that are beautifully decorated for the holidays. And they're celebrating the joy of Christmas. They have short-term rehab and long-term care nursing under the direction of their administrator, Carol McClure. And again, Wilson, we love having you here, and you have a beautiful daughter.
Thank you very much. No, I love it, and I love all the houses up here in Concord. I love it. I got to move up here sometime. I'm saying. Now, listen,
one thing
I haven't done. I've done the Fox TV, Fox Charlotte, Fox News Rising, Monday through Friday, 5 to 9 in the morning. I've never read about a float in a parade. Could I read about the next one? Could I tell everybody?
Sure.
Could I do that?
Yes.
Is this the one right now?
That's the one.
Hey, step into Christmas in style with Motion Dance Studio in downtown Concord. We offer classes for age 2 and up in ballet, tap, jazz, hip-hop, lyrical, modern, all kinds of dances that I could never do. Motion Dance Studio, owned by Gina Motz and Holly Westbrook. Parade float sponsored by Peterson Grading. And, man, they're having a great one. Check them out online, motiondance.com. What a great-looking group right there. Motion Dance. Oh, look at that. Man, I tell you, ladies, I don't know about y'all. If I did one of them kicks, I wouldn't be able to walk for about a week and a half.
We could let you take over, Wilson. I tell you what.
We're going to have to get some fast-talking lessons from you.
Well, you know.
We get tongue-tied a lot, and then we get just the silly giggles.
Just ask the mayor. He's a good fast-talker.
Well, I'm not so sure about that. But that was a great article in the Charlotte Observer about you a couple of weeks ago. Thoroughly enjoyed reading that.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, we even brought it with us.
Oh,
you know,
good.
We've got it right there. Yeah. And that was so we would be sure to recognize you.
No,
and now we have
Miss
Kristen Billings, America's Miss 2012. She lives here in Concord. And she has a son, Zachary, who is 15. Oh, she doesn't look old enough to have a 15-year-old. So this is Miss Kristen Billings. Welcome. Merry Christmas. This is always one of my favorites, Suzanne.
And this is Concord First Assembly. And A Christmas Carol comes alive on stage for Intune School of the Arts annual community production on December 14th, 15th, and 16th at the Concord First Assembly's main auditorium. The show spotlights the entertainer Joe Phillips and his role as the penny-pitching miserly Scrooge. Oh, and I think all the ghosts visit them. Christmas past and Christmas present and Christmas future.
What a float, Suzanne. That is just unbelievable.
That is beautifully done. Beautifully done.
Great job. Merry Christmas.
Now, tickets are on sale. You can go to www.concordchristmas.com for more information.
If the costumes are anything, like, I mean, that must be a fabulous production. It just looks great. Next, we have THS of Kannapolis. They are a skilled nursing facility offering both short-term rehab and long-term care. And their specialty is rehab to home. That's a great motto. Merry Christmas.
We're very fortunate to have groups like Transitional Health Services in our area.
And following the float is one of their vans. Yeah, you know, this is becoming more and more a thing as we're, a lot of us are getting older and having to have surgery. We need to go into place for rehab, with hip replacements, knee replacements. But let's hope that's no time soon.
The rate I'm going today, I need a brain replacement. And we have Dance Expressions coming up. Good afternoon. Now, Dance Expressions is a rapidly growing studio located in Afton Village. They offer ballet, jazz, tap, hip-hop, competition, and they do boys hip-hop for ages 3 through adult. So it's owned by Stephanie Hebert, former NBA Charlotte Bobcats dancer. And we're so glad you're in our parade this afternoon.
They've got some tiny ones.
And we have a rain dog riding. It's not a reindeer, it's a rain dog. They do have some tiny ones.
Merry Christmas. And they look so cute in their pink.
They do. And all that energy is, like you said before, from coming all the way up there down to here, and they still are full of energy. So we're so tickled to see these young ones come through.
Next, we have a lot of pretty girls on here. This is the Cabarrus County Fair float. And the mini Miss Cabarrus County Fair is Sarah Clark, and she's the 9-year-old daughter of Stephen and Kelly Clark of Harrisburg. Little Miss Cabarrus County Fair is Aliyah Wynn, and she is the 11-year-old daughter of Crystal and Buckluck and Tri Wynn of Matthews. And then Junior Miss Cabarrus County Fair is Kiara Kelly, and she's 13 years old. And Miss Cabarrus County Fair is Erica Shoup, and she is the 17-year-old daughter of Chuck and Melissa Shoup of Harrisburg. And going back to Kiara Kelly, she is the 13-year-old daughter of Brian and Elaine Kelly of Concord.
Lovely young ladies.
Oh, they're all beautiful.
And we have Midland Fire and Rescue. This is their Squad 2 and Foam 1. Squad 2 is a 2012 Ford F-55 quick response unit that responds to medical calls in the Midland Fire District. And Foam 1 carries 500 gallons of firefighting foam. I think a lot of times that foam will work where water will not. That's for the large flammable liquid fires.
And the Rescue 2 that is passing us now is a light rescue unit that carries rescue equipment including rope, airbags, and hydraulic rescue tools. And it was donated to Midland by the Cabarrus Rescue Squad. Oh, I recognize some of these ladies.
I do, too. Some of our favorite young ladies. This is Cabarrus County Senior Centers. They provide recreational client services, educational activities, wellness activities, and outreach for older adults, adults with disabilities, and their families. And excuse me, I don't think any one of them are a day over 29.
They are an active group.
They are that. That keeps them young.
Merry
Christmas, everyone.
You know, I think the wind has died down a little bit.
I think it's changed direction, judging by the flags flying over there. It's coming across that way. It just doesn't feel quite so cold.
Our next entry is from Advanced Home Care. Once again, it's another place I think that you can have rehab or home care as you need it. So we welcome them to our parade this year. And they've got a beautiful Christmas tree on top of their van. That is really unusual. I like that. Oh, and there's a cute rain girl. Is that what we'd call her?
Rudolphina.
Rudolphina. I love it. Love it. Love it.
Teresa, we have the Mount Pleasant Homecoming Queen. This is Holiday Dees. Isn't she lovely?
Oh, beautiful. And look at that tiara. I like that one.
And I like the red Mustang. It's all for Christmas. Oh, and she's got her tiger for the Mount Pleasant Tigers in there. He's all decorated with some sparkly tinsel. And our Mount Pleasant Air Force Junior ROTC.
Suzanne, I think this ROTC has grown a lot in the last couple of years. I don't remember seeing but just a few entries over the past few years.
It's almost like every one of our schools represented here today have a ROTC unit. I may or may not, but it seems that way, and we are very proud to have them with us.
I agree. Once again, we appreciate all the work that they do in our communities while they're still in high school. And I think I hear a band, which I would think would probably be the Mount Pleasant High School Band. Their cheerleaders appear to be in front. Sounds like another good band.
And I love their blue and gold uniforms.
Too. And they're performing for us as they come by. Once again, they stay so cheerful all the way till the end. Merry Christmas.
Big, beautiful smiles.
Uh-huh. Some dentists or orthodontists must have been very busy because they do have beautiful smiles. Be their flag girls coming by.
And all in their red and white for Christmas. Let's listen to the band.
Great band. Sounds wonderful. Well, boy, we've got some people here ready for Christmas. This is from Sonics America's Drive-In in a 1952 Willie's Army Jeep. But what's really impressive is these females on skates and the Sonic Chicken. Go Chicken!
Is that the Funky Chicken?
I think it might be. Boy, they're all decked out.
Love the Army Jeep. That is so cool.
And they've got Rudolph in the front.
And candy canes and a wreath, he really is decorated.
We have seen a lot of beautiful floats so far today, and I know we have a lot more to come.
We have, and you know, we're so fortunate in this area to have a lot of dance studios, great dance studios, and this is Dance Track. They're in the Mount Pleasant area, and they offer tap, jazz, ballet, point, lyrical, hip-hop, acrobatics, Zumba, and competition teams.
And they're all right there together.
Look at those kicks. Great kicks, girls.
Way to go. Look at the little one there. She's just keeping right up with everyone.
They say dancing helps build confidence, and I can see why.
Oh, most definitely so. Next, we have the City of Concord Electric Systems hybrid cart driven by Scott Chun, and I believe Scott has his wife with him in the vehicle. They're doing their part to conserve energy. Glad to have y'all here in the parade.
Now, hybrid's not all electric. It does something with battery and gas, I think.
I think so, too. I think that's why you have
to brush up on that. I just now got a phone without an antenna, so, you know, we're getting there. This is City of Concord's Electric Systems. This is one of their working height bucket trucks. Now, they earn, our electric system here has earned state and national recognitions for safety, reliability, including 6 RP Diamond level utilities in the United States. And there was a great article not too long ago, just last week or earlier this week, of the electric system employees helping with Hurricane Sandy. So kudos to these guys who left their safe, warm homes and families and went up to see what they could help do with our neighbors.
And they totally volunteered to do that, which is great also. Next we have Friendship Southern Baptist, Pastor Jesse Watkins and his band of Merry Hunters stole along to advertise their wild game dinner on January the 26th. I believe this is a new entry, isn't it?
It is.
Okay, Friendship Southern Baptist Church, welcome. And we'll look forward to January 26th. We'll come on down.
They could fit right into Duck Dynasty, too.
Oh, they do venison, duck, squirrel, rabbit. Well, you name it, they cook it.
And Waste Pro of North Carolina became part of the Concord community in 2011. And they provide solid waste and recycling collection here.
And they have really done an excellent job having the larger recycling containers. I think it's made it a lot easier on all of us.
Yeah, those are just absolutely great.
Next, we have the Concord Kannapolis Area Transit Rider, operated by First Transit, and their motto is, "If you can't do it safely, don't do it." And the operator employee of the year is Kimberly Bell, and they took over services of Rider on July 1st of this year.
And this entry is Christmas in Heaven by Wilmar Park Baptist Church. They always do a beautiful job with their floats. This float depicts what our imaginations and what the Bible says heaven looks like. Streets paved of gold, walls of jasper, sapphire, and rubies, along with Jesus, the angels, and the citizens of heaven. That's a well-done float. And in addition, this is a 1930 Model A owned by Doris and O'Brien Benton of Concord. And riding today is Reverend Michael Light of the Wilmar Park Baptist Church and his wife Tiffany. Merry Christmas.
We're certainly seeing some beautiful old cars coming by right now.
We are. You know, Reverend Light moved from Tennessee, but he was formerly from Burlington, North Carolina, so he's kind of come back home.
Well, welcome back. Next is a 1928 Model A Ford replica with rumble seat, exact body trim as a 1928 Model A, and it's owned by Don and Diane Schutte. Thanks for coming here today.
The beautiful car. Beautiful. Look at the rumble seat.
Oh, with the bow on the back. Oh, that's great. Wonderful.
Now we have our little Rowan Cinderella Sweetheart Queen, Miss Emma Nicole Henson. She's 18 months old. isn't she beautiful? And I think she was just crowned like in the last week or so.
She is gorgeous.
Her parents are Ashley Henson and Phil Jones. And her grandparents are Michael and Brenda Delaney.
Next, we have the North Carolina Royalty State Court, and there are a lot of queens on here. I'll try to get through as many as I can. We have Princess Cheyenne Nicholson, Ambassador Zoe Hodge, Ambassador Cassie Edwards, Baby Miss Braylon Honeycutt, Miniature Miss Frankie Gardner, Tiny Miss Kennedy Locklear, Little Miss Massey Lee, Junior Miss Grayson Honeycutt. They're all beautiful. I'm afraid I'm not going to be able to get all of their names in. Teen Miss Alexandra Spawn and Miss Katie Edwards. Sorry if I missed any of your names.
Teresa, this is the Cabarrus County Sheriff's Office Special Vehicle Response Team, SVRT for short. They were formed in October 2010. We also have their bomb squad here. And their special response team, which is SWAT from the Sheriff's Office. This truck, I think, is operated by David Logan. The bomb squad provides training to government institutions and private businesses and schools. And the SVRT team members attend group training events that go individually to classes for certifications in like EMT certification, man search tracking, multi-agency land search training. And those ATVs come in awfully handy when they're out and about.
They sure do. And we do appreciate all of the work that they do in just all areas that they are in. Next, we've got the entry from the 2012 Harrisburg Miss 4th of July. Driver Michael Mayberry, Wee Baby, Riley Hutchins, Baby, Kylie O'Neill, Tiny Ava Sakaris. Sakaris, what'd you think?
Sakaris.
Okay. Minnie Riston Shield, Little Eliza Minor, Preteen Grayson Honeycutt, Teen Kaylin Embler, Junior Miss Paula Rogue, Miss Courtney Stellman, and Mrs. Hope Meat. Thank you for coming.
And here's some wonderful looking young dancers here from the Next Step Dance Studio. And they're located in the heart of NASCAR country, right here in Concord. Students perform annually in NBA, NASCAR, and NCAA events in the Metrolina area. They're the only one in the Charlotte area that maintains a complete guys-only program that includes tumble, tap, hip-hop, and breakdance. And I see Miss Melissa McDaniel there, who is also teaches dance at Cannon School.
Oh, great.
It's owned by Teresa Malone and Stephanie Sloop, and the instructions are, of course, and there is Miss Stephanie right there.
I thought I recognized her.
Merry Christmas. Asia Alexis, Lindsay Wagner, who also comes out to the school, Stephanie Foltz, Corey Brown, Whitney Thompson, and Genia Horvath.
Think Cabarrus First is Cabarrus County's Buy Local campaign. And this is a fairly new organization. Shift your shopping this holiday season and buy from locally owned businesses. And I think that's a very great thing. More money stays within our community to help build our local economy. Supporting businesses are on with the float, but to find out more, you can go to www.thinkcabarrusfirst. So this is Think Cabarrus First, buy locally. And there's Elvis. He is alive.
But I think Elvis is leaving the parade.
He's buying local, all right.
And I saw a dear friend and co-worker, Joy Pinto. It was, of course, their truck. And Lydia was walking around. Lydia ran earlier.
Wow. She ran, and now she's on a float.
And what a great radio station, 103.7. Country's hottest hits. Now say that three times real fast. They have Catherine Lane midday and Charlie and Debbie in the afternoon. And there's a big, sexy evening show.
All right. Next we have Christmas K 104.7, the Todd Baker Morning Show, 6 a.m. to 10. Brenda Matthews midday, Brandon Chase in the afternoon, and Kate Hall in the evenings. Welcome.
What a great, great bunch of young athletes, the Cabarrus County Gymnastics. Largest, most successful, and fastest growing gymnastics club in Cabarrus County. They've recently renovated their offices, obviously because they have lots and lots of students out there. Their motto at Cabarrus County Gymnastics is to promote healthy, happy, and responsible kids through the sports of gymnastics.
They're doing a great job out here. Oh, that split looked painful to me.
Look at that. I think they call those walkovers, I'm not sure.
We need to catch up on them terms.
A backflip on asphalt. Oh my goodness. Oh my heavens.
Wow.
That's just amazing.
That is great.
Wow.
We are so excited to have Carolina Courts in Concord that just opened this summer. I believe it was in June they opened. It's a family-friendly, state-of-the-art, indoor, multi-use sports facility located in downtown Concord. If you have not been to Carolina Courts, please go visit. It is a great facility.
It is a beautiful facility. We are so fortunate to have them here.
They do basketball, volleyball, all ages. Oh, and look at this little one here. Yes. So Carolina Courts, once again, if you've not even, go visit it. It's great. They do a lot. It's walkable to the shops and restaurants. And please visit their website if you can't get there, www.carolinacourts.com, for more information about renting space there. So we're so happy to have them in downtown Concord.
Oh, this beautiful float of angels with angels on it is from Head to Toe Salon and Spa. We have 18 hairstylists, 4 nail techs, 4 massage therapists, 2, I can't say it again, estheticians to serve you, and a partridge in a pear tree. We love you, ladies. And look, you all look beautiful.
And the heels, you're still standing. Oh, are those not great? I love those.
You know, they're right up there on Church Street. Again, you know, great gift certificates. Mm-hmm. They've opened a second little shop behind them for their massage and nail tech. So,
oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, yeah.
Next, we have the Prodigy All-Stars. This is a competitive cheerleading program located in Concord. Prodigy All-Star also offers tumble classes, stunt classes, school camp, summer camp, and after-school care. And they are the 2011 North Carolina State Champions and 2012 Battle of the Beach National Champions. Congratulations, Prodigy All-Stars.
Great job, y'all. That's exciting.
Good job. Oh, Suzanne, well, they're not quite there. They're doing some tumbling coming up. Mm-hmm. I just happened to see down the street. Yeah, they are.
Oh, my heavens.
Oh, here they go. They're getting ready to do another stunt.
Right in front of the judges. Wow.
Sorry, I took my breath away.
So glad we do not have overhead wires.
No, that was unbelievable.
Amazing.
Great. Excellent. We thoroughly enjoyed that.
And again, this is their van here.
Great. I think they're getting ready to
graphics here too.
Oh my heavens!
I couldn't see around the corner.
Susan, you may have had a heart attack if you saw it. Maybe just as well you did not see that. I couldn't do that in my best of days.
I dream, you know. I can dream. I can dream about being a beautiful princess in a red convertible too. This is Miss Cox Mill High School.
Wow.
Desiree Watley is the 2012 Miss Cox Mill High School.
What a beautiful girl and dress.
And she's a recent graduate and currently attending CPCC and pursuing a acting career. She's absolutely beautiful. And riding with Desiree is Anna McCord. And we have the Cox Mill High School cheerleaders. And we love that purple and black. That's a great combination. Y'all look beautiful out there.
All got those ribbons in their hair. Look at this cute guy. We're talking about you too.
Let's listen to the Cox Mill High School School Band. Really sounded wonderful.
I would hate to be judging the bands this year. Our judges up there, they're really going to have it cut out for them this year. Next, coming up on the motorcycles, we have the Marine Corps League, Cabarrus Detachment. Is that Corporal Wilson, first class, is driving one of the motorcycles?
Or they may be, we've got another vehicle, so okay. We were trying to get some information about there.
Okay. Okay. The Marine Corps League perpetuates the traditions and spirit of all Marines and Navy FFM courtsmen who proudly wear or who have worn the eagle. Thank you so much for what you do.
We really appreciate it so much.
And they do the Toys for Tots, which is another great thing that we can appreciate that they do for us. Thank you.
Go ahead. Yeah. This is a, I think it's a 7-ton truck, and they can carry up to a 30,000-pound payload to transport troop cargo and supplies.
That's one big truck.
And I believe this was Corporal Wilson in first class Gall in that
Thank
truck.
Thank you, Suzanne. Yeah, I got a little messed up
That's
there.
That's big, big truck.
Next, we have the Concord High School Fire Academy. First of all, we have the Walkers. And this program recruits take state certification classes to become volunteers. And what a great looking group of people, young men and women. And whoever is driving the fire truck already knows how to use the siren extremely well. There are now 14 high school fire academies statewide following our lead. So Merry Christmas from the Concord High School Fire Academy and Chief David Barlow.
This is Engine 10. I believe it's a 2011 unit, I think.
It looks new.
Yeah.
Once again, we appreciate what these young people are doing starting out early to learn all of this information, to learn how to do the safety.
This is one of our Mount Pleasant Independence Day Queen. This is our teen miss, Lily Allman. She's 17 years old and a senior at Mount Pleasant High School. The daughter of Tina and Barry Klein. Lovely, lovely, lovely girls we've had today.
And her tiara, I like it. It's a little different shape than some of the others we've seen.
I think we would have to line them all up, and then we could pick which one we like the best.
I think that's a wonderful idea. Ooh, here comes another red Corvette. And this has the 2012 Tiny Miss Mount Pleasant Independence Day, Macy Reese Harwood. The 2012 Little Miss Mount Pleasant Independence Day, Brianna Christine Harwood. And Macy and Brianna are the daughters of Shelley and Brian Harwood of Mount Pleasant, and both attend Mount Pleasant Elementary School. Can you imagine having both of your daughters at Beauty Queens already?
That'd be something. I think their wardrobe fund is quite high.
Yeah, I'm not sure I would want to have to buy all the clothes for that.
And this is Junior Miss Mount Pleasant Independence Day, Emma McClay Barbie. And she's 12 years old and a 7th grader at Mount Pleasant Middle School. And she loves dancing, and I think she's currently dancing at Center Stage Dance Company, and she loves cheering for Mount Pleasant Middle School.
Are these maybe new to our parade this year, Suzanne?
No, well, maybe the participants in it, but okay. Never the Correll family. They have been with us on the parade for many years, but I believe I see some superheroes this year.
I do too. This is the Correll family, and their characters have come out today to spread the joy of the holiday season. Well, they certainly are an impressive looking group.
Now, I know Captain America, I know Thor, we have Batman, Batgirl, we've got Wonder Woman, we've got Supergirl,
and Luke, I am your father.
You are amazing with these characters. You just amaze me every year. Okay, you're still on. You're still on.
Oh my. Well, I think Miss Piggy and Kermit, love them, Iron Man, I can't think of their names, but I love you guys. And Transformers and The Incredible Hulk. How'd that do? Did I do pretty good?
I thought that was really amazing.
I believe Ms. Correll used to. Now, I don't know if she still does or not, but she used to make all the outfits for the entries. They used to have great big like puppets and things like that walking and... They're just amazing, amazing family.
Great outfits.
Oh, and we have Logan Community Daycare. We have King, Queen, Prince and Princess, Santana Sowell, Talmisha Frontis, Leon, and Natonia Bush, Zachariah Drake, Cadence Wilson. All beautiful young men and women there from our Logan Community Daycare.
They always put out such a beautiful float. All right, Suzanne, I keep saying it's one of our favorites, but we have a lot of favorites in this parade.
Shake, Shanora.
And this is Merry Christmas from Booger Woods for the cure of cystic fibrosis. It's one of the oldest and most fun honks in the Carolinas. It just celebrated its 35th anniversary. Just watch them shake it. There they go.
We absolutely, absolutely love the work that they do to raise money for cystic fibrosis.
And it's totally volunteers, 100 volunteers.
Absolutely. And you know, they've even had the Booger Busters up at the Cruise Inn in Kannapolis a couple of times.
Wow.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So we love seeing them up there. Great job y'all do. And maybe that's part of the Rat Pack.
Hello. Maybe. Oh, those costumes are unbelievable.
Teresa, this part of the volunteers, I think, for Central Piedmont Search and Rescue. They're nonprofit organizations who specialize in search and rescue of lost persons.
What a worthy cause.
Absolutely. And they also, of course, have their animals that help them that are specially trained.
It just seems like the last couple months we've had several people gone missing. And, you know, just to have that, for the families to have that support that know that someone's out there looking. We know that the police and all are looking, but just additional.
Absolutely. It's like the Civil Air Patrol. You know, the volunteers that go around and fight and help. I'm assuming it's still around. So we've got help on the ground, too. And it is, a nonprofit volunteer organization.
And they seem to use a lot of different dogs, not all one kind. I'm sure it takes a lot of training.
Well, I would think the Huskies are pretty good to go through rough territory and have the stamina to do that. Of course, bloodhounds with their noses and...
There's still several... The dogs are wanting to stop. The children are wanting to pet the dogs, and they're having a good time doing that. I believe our next vehicle would be Alliance Medical. Yes, Alliance Medical, Inc. offers a complete line of the most up-to-date medical equipment and supplies to meet the need of patients at home. And once again, we appreciate this, that they can keep people at home and come in and take care of them. Since 1990, they have assisted residents of Stanley, Montgomery, and surrounding counties by providing all types of services, from hospital beds to bathing aids. Once again, this is, you know, we're our country and people are getting older. We're going to need more and more of this type of home care.
You're exactly right. And, of course, with them are Home Care of the Carolinas. And their goal is to help you stay at home so that you're not in a skilled facility somewhere, that you're not in a nursing home, that you're able to stay in your own home.
Next, we have Bath Fitter is your choice for one-day bath remodeling. They've been in Cabarrus County since 2004, and I've got to give them a plug. They did my bathtub. And they do it in one day, which is pretty
amazing. And gosh, look how fabulous
that
looks.
Oh, what a float. Wow. They got the bubbles, the shower, the tub, the whole thing. So what they can install a new tub right over your old one, or convert it to an easy access walk-in shower if that's neat. And you can call them for a free estimate. And like I said, we did this to my bathroom several years ago.
Well, we have Restoration Plus Services Incorporated. They're a local disaster restoration company. Specializes in insurance claim, and I think there might be a claim coming because it looks like their house is on fire.
That is great.
Of course, with insurance claims, it's fire, smoke, water, and mold. They're licensed, and they've been serving Rowan and Cabarrus counties. That was a cute float. Cute
that was
idea.
Great. Next, we have the Cabarrus Animal Rescue is a new animal rescue nonprofit organization dedicated to rescuing homeless and surrendered pets and finding them new forever homes. All animals are vetted, spayed, and neutered and microchipped before being adopted out. Their kennels are located at Crestmont Drive, Concord. So this is the Cabarrus Animal Rescue. And they've got some, oh, look at the dogs. They're all dressed up. Great.
Oh, and some big dogs. Big dogs and little dogs.
Thanks for coming today. Whoa, look at this.
Oh, my goodness. This is the Bouncing for Fun Party Rentals.
Stay healthy and stay active, everyone.
Sorry, it's Rowan Regional Medical Center.
We wish you guys the
best. You go, guys.
You're all beautiful. Merry Christmas to you. Yes, make some noise for us, for the cameras, for the crews, and for your own family.
Well, they are having a lot of fun on their Live Healthy float, and that was some local staff and families that want to remind you to still stay healthy this holiday season.
That made me want to get up and dance.
That's kind of boogieing on down there, I do.
Next, we've got Bouncing for Fun Party Rentals. They're located in Davidson, North Carolina, and they're owned by Renee Hudson, and we have... I got a cheat sheet on this one. Pooh, Hello Kitty, and SpongeBob. Just a few of the characters that they can do. And that's Bouncing for Fun Party Rentals. Sounds like a great addition to a party.
It does.
Get those guys in the front of them and get them. You got it going.
And that's a big old pizza.
Ooh.
We have Pizza Hut Wings and Pizza Car. I don't see the Wing Street Chicken, but we've got... the world's best pizza sitting back there. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Pizza was voted the best pizza by the Independent Tribune, and they've got a great lunch buffet, so stop by, fill up.
They do. That buffet is, oh, it's a killer for me. Next, we have the City of Concord Recognized Neighborhood Program, Partnerships for Stronger Neighborhoods. It's a program designed to build relationships with neighborhood organizations within the city in an effort to enhance the quality of life. And I think that we have representatives from a lot of the different neighborhoods here in the City of Concord. There are 53 officially recognized neighborhoods. Congratulations. Thanks for coming today. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Oh, Teresa, you know, we were talking about Girl Scouts earlier. Well, this is part of the Cabarrus Girl Scout group celebrating 100 years this year. This is Brownie Troop 268. They're dressed as some snow angels back there. We have Santa elves. We have, of course, in their vest with all their badges and ribbons and stars and things that they earn from the various projects that they do. And we have Girl Scout Troop 2457 and Troop 2020. And we're very happy to have y'all with us, and Merry Christmas, everyone.
Oh, we have the North Stanley High School Marching Comets from New London, North Carolina. The last 3 years, they have won Spirit of Christmas Award and Best Band in the Albemarle Christmas Parade. And they look wonderful. Great group of students.
I think we're going to get a little music here. Have Girl Scout Troop 2975. I believe this is part of the Trailblazers group. And Troop 1138. You know, these gals love to help the community with service projects, especially during the holiday. And they would like to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas. And, of course, 2012 was the 100th anniversary of Girl Scouts. So this has been a very special year for them.
There are a lot of girls coming by.
Merry Christmas. There's Troop 1328. And some little reindeers there. And, of course, there are great signs that are from the Trailblazer Girl Scouts.
We just see so many good organizations in this parade that do so much for the community.
We really do. Ooh. And, of course, this is the Girl Scouts that were... Yeah. All dressed as angels, and their troop is at Bethpage Presbyterian Church.
Don't
what
they
a beautiful,
look
beautiful, beautiful, beautiful young ladies.
And I guess they've been singing the whole way.
They probably won't have much of a voice tomorrow.
No. Well, it's getting a little cooler now.
It is, a little chillier. The sun's gone back behind the buildings, but... we're not far from the end. We're over halfway, if that makes everybody a little warmer.
First Baptist Church in Mount Pleasant. Their theme is Jesus is the Light. They are a Southern Baptist church growing in God's love. And you can see Jesus is the Light with beautiful candles they have. Sunday school is at 9:15 a.m. and worship is at 10:30. So we welcome the First Baptist Church from Mount Pleasant to our parade.
And what a beautiful float.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful.
Oh, and all the candles are lit in memory of different people. It's absolutely beautiful.
I'm glad you noticed that. I did not notice that.
Well, Teresa, a lot of us know these good people up here. This is from Cabarrus Family Medicine. There are 300 staff members who make up Cabarrus Family Medicine in the Concord and the surrounding area. And they provide comprehensive relationship-based health care from pediatrics to geriatrics. They're truly the specialists we never outgrow. So welcome, Cabarrus Family Medicine.
And they've got some good music going.
They did.
And a lot of participants. Our next fire engine is from Georgeville Volunteer Fire Department. It's engine number 2 with sirens.
And lights.
Well, are we going to get it here, the siren?
There we go. Woo! You know, it is not an entry from Georgeville without that siren. So we love you guys. And thank you for all the hard work you put in for our community.
We hadn't heard a siren in a little while. It's about time to hear one.
I don't think we had quite as many emergency units as we've had in the past. So it was a little bit easier to put floats with music in.
Okay.
And spread them out and not upset animals and young children.
Yeah. So, yeah, we definitely don't want to do that.
It can be a little difficult arranging everybody in the parade sometimes.
Well, you and your husband, Johnny, do a fantastic job of doing that because I know it takes a lot of work.
And Brenda Dry could not
do it without
Brenda.
So. Yeah, I'm sure when you get all the entries, shuffling them as to who goes where. Oh, here comes something.
My goodness gracious. Well, we've got H&H Towing, and look what they're towing. We've got some old, and we've got some new, and we've got some fast and slow, I guess. They've been in Concord since 2001, and they do local and long-distance heavy equipment hauling. I guess that's a dragster. Not sure that's gas. I think they'd run like methanol or something really high octane stuff, and boy did we get a whiff of it. We have another one of their big trucks coming, and you know they have decorated these trucks for the holidays. They look absolutely beautiful.
Well, on that first one, that Volkswagen was my first car, just like that.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna let that Dragster be my last car. That's what I want to do next. That's on my bucket list. Now, we're actually hauling heavy equipment. We've got the little Bobcat and is that called a trencher, maybe? I'm not sure what these equipment things are, but look, they're wrapped up for Christmas. So somebody's going to get a nice present.
They really go all out on decorating. It's just amazing.
Really
the work that goes into so many of these floats and entries, though, they do a lot of work. They don't just show up.
And we have some beautiful professional floats that it's, you know, easy to rent, get on it, ride it, and you're done. But you're right. Some of the work that goes into these, like the churches and the schools, that they do their own float. And because I tell you, all we did was put a little red sparkly stuff on the judges' stand, and it was rough today.
This is the Concord Taekwondo. Wow, look at them. They're excited. I'm glad to have them here in our parade today. They're showing us some of their kicks and some of their moves.
Now, Taekwondo is different than karate. It's a whole different mind thing.
They kick higher.
Okay. That's good. Oh, my goodness. You do kick higher. Wow.
All right. Way to go. Thanks for showing us that.
That's amazing. Now, and I think discipline, self-esteem, not just the physical aspect of the sport, but the inner stuff and the mental stuff goes along with it. So,
Merry Christmas. Well, that was another young, interesting group coming by. Well, they had a few older people on there, too.
Well, they did. I guess maybe they have stayed in shape over the years, maybe.
Well, once again, it's just another beautiful parade in Concord. And once again, want to thank ACN for sponsoring us. Couldn't do it without them.
Nope. And the City of Concord couldn't do it without them. And also, Crown Productions.
Yes.
They're out here in the cold with us. They're doing all our videotaping, so everyone can see this on Channel 22 later on. So we thank them. Now we have our Natural Elite Beauty Queens for the year 2012-13. Aren't they gorgeous?
Beautiful.
This is a semi-glitz pageant. I don't know, you know, you may not know about semi-glitz versus glitz, but if you watch Toddlers and Tiaras, you do. but Natural Elite is designed to build self-confidence, poise, and generosity in our ladies. At Natural Elite, they sparkle, shine, and are all things divine.
Love it.
I want that needle pointed on a pillow. That's absolutely great words to live by. And we also have the Natural Beauties for 2012 and 13 from the NC State Royalty Pageant. We have kings and queens. Look at those precious little ones.
They are so cute.
And Natural Beauties is a natural pageant system open up to boys and girls.
Now we've got Cub Scout Pack 38. The boys are 7 to 12, walking and marching as a unit. And don't they look great?
They do.
I'm not sure what they're saying, but they're excited.
I just hope they're staying good and warm. Probably the walk will do that for them.
Yes, I think it probably will. That's one good thing when you're not just on a float, but if you're walking, I would think you'd be a lot warmer.
I see a tiger. And this is the On the Run convenience store. So please visit the local On the Runs where their motto is fast, fresh, and friendly. We have the tiger van. And it's even decorated for Christmas.
And it looks like they're having a good time in the van. They're bouncing along.
Yeah. They'll even make you a fresh pot of coffee. Love the paint job on that van. It's really cool.
Probst Brothers Distributor Incorporated. For 75 years, they have provided Cabarrus County with excellent customer service, backed by lasting customer relationships. Merry Christmas, Probst Brothers. Thanks for being in the parade today. So, you have not started your shopping?
No, I haven't. I don't even have a list to make yet or check twice. So, but we'll get that done soon. We've got such a great crowd this afternoon. Is everybody having a good time? Yeah. Oh, come on. How good a time are you really having?
There we go.
Well, we are so glad you're with us this afternoon. We are always get excited this time of year that Cabarrus Events Association, along with our sponsors, can put this parade on for you. So we love doing it. And so glad for the turnout. Well, F&M Bank was voted the best bank again in 2012.
Congratulations!
And this is the double-decker bus with several of the employees and little ones riding on it.
I do love those buses.
Yeah. And like all the other banks and so many of our other services, you can do just about anything online now.
Oh, Oh, and here's Snowman from FNM. Thanks for joining us. In our next vehicle, we have Miss Metrolina's outstanding teen, Casey Carson. She's the 15-year-old daughter of Thomas and Misty Carson of Charlotte. And once again, another beautiful young lady. I'm so glad they're wearing coats today.
I know. They do have some beautiful gowns and dresses, but they would have frozen today. Now, Teresa, this is Odyssey Athletics. They're a cheer and dance program located in Harrisburg. And you hear them cheering right now. Merry Christmas. They have great coaches that teach dance, and the staff want to instill life skills such as good work ethic, responsibility, dedication, and self-motivation. They've got a highly respected staff out there and a training center that is sure to provide each child a comfortable atmosphere to learn.
I think they may be a little hoarse tomorrow, too. Voices might not be so strong. We have the Cabarrus County Sheriff's Office and Kannapolis City Police Department School Resource and DARE Officers Program. This is such a wonderful program. From being a middle school teacher, we love the DARE program. It's a great thing
it
for
is.
Our schools. And these officers work extremely hard to protect your schools and students and to educate children also. Really appreciate all that these officers do for us. Look at that. That's just a great picture of what downtown looks like.
Isn't that beautiful? And we still have enough leaves on the trees to show the color. It's been a pretty fall.
It has been one of the prettier ones.
Mm-hmm. Of course, we just have an absolutely beautiful town that we live in.
Well, we do.
And absolutely beautiful restaurants to go eat in.
And there's Alan.
Like Union Street Bistro. Full service restaurant and catering. And they do off-site catering for anywhere from 20 to 200 people. So they're located right downtown in historic Concord, and they have a great Sunday buffet.
Yes, they do. They do. And their catering is outstanding also. This is the RE/MAX hot air balloon, if you couldn't tell already. It's a symbol of real estate excellence worldwide for 40 years.
That's the only warm spot on the whole parade route.
Right,
you feel the heat over here.
Star.
And Grinch, you better not steal Christmas.
Oh, what a great float. You will see these hot air balloons at charity and school events, as well as fairs, festivals, and air shows across the country. This float is sponsored by the local RE/MAX Leading Edge and their real estate professionals.
Now we have some more beautiful young women. This is Katie Thompson. She's the homecoming queen for Hickory Ridge High School. She's 17. And she's actually the cheerleading captain, so she got to ride in a warm car rather than march today. She's also the yearbook editor, and she's senior class vice president.
Next we have Blair Lucas, and she is the 2012 Miss Hickory Ridge High School. She is a sophomore at Hickory Ridge, and today she's accompanied by her father. And another beautiful young lady. What a pretty white dress. Beautiful white dress.
Now we've got Hickory Ridge High School football team, and they are the SPC champs. Give them a big hand.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, everyone. That's a great accomplishment there.
Merry Christmas. Congratulations.
Great job, Raging Bulls. Go. And this is their football team part two.
Congratulations.
Those are some big guys. They couldn't get them all on one float.
Congratulations,
everybody. Go Bulls.
And now we've got the Hickory Ridge High School Band. In the past 5 years, the Blue Regiment has received over 200 first or second place awards. We definitely want to listen to them.
Sounded wonderful, and you know we do band awards every year at the Christmas parades, and it's very difficult to judge bands.
I can't imagine the
sound. You know, is everybody holding their instrument on the same line, and are they on the same foot and straight lines and all kinds of things? So, good luck to them. They sounded wonderful.
I can see why they've won so many awards. Now, Suzanne, this looks like this
excellent.
Might be somebody near and dear to your heart.
Yes, it is. A little partial to Cannon School. Go Cougars! We have our athletes, artists, and scholars on our board our Christmas tree this year. There's Mr. Davis. We're members of our jazz band and some of our athletes there. There's Hudson and Charlotte up there. We got a little dancing going on the back. It's designed and decorated to highlight the artists in their jazz band. And then they had some of our athletes from football, baseball, and lacrosse. And we also have a homecoming king and queen. Ian Hicks is our homecoming queen this year. And Sally Fowler is our homecoming queen.
Congratulations.
And they're driven by Tom Booker. Merry Christmas, guys. So glad you're here.
Merry Christmas. We got Action Cleanup Restoration, a division of Don Doherty Construction Company, 1971... M3FA Army truck. Oh, the truck is coming up in just a second. They take care of all water and fire cleanup. Just give them a call. Action Cleanup and Restoration, a division of Don Doherty Construction. This is our large loss catastrophe unit.
And we have Muse Residential. They do furniture and home decor. It's a beautiful fabric there.
That was
they
a
have
beautiful
fabrics,
float.
Wallpaper, carpet, do full service remodeling. Some pretty fabrics on that float.
Our next vehicle is from the Charlotte Motor Speedway. Last year was the first year they had their light show. It's really fantastic. If you have not been to see it, you can just drive right through it if you want to. You don't even have to get out of
the
car.
Don't have to get out. Don't have to get cold.
And it's, once again, at Charlotte Motor Speedway. So if you've driven by and wondered why all those lights are out there, that's what it's for. You drive around the speedway.
We kind of took a daytime pass around the area so you could kind of see where all the lights were and the different setups and groups, and they've got some great ones out there.
And there's a skating rink, I believe, also. A lot of you can buy hot chocolate and just a lot of different things to do. So if you haven't done that, that would be a great opportunity.
Teresa, this truck is the Winda Gang, and they're a window cleaning, pressure washing company. They're a local family owned franchise, and they've been in business for 18 years.
Merry Christmas. I need to come get them to come wash my windows.
Tis the season. You got to get sparkly for Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Yeah, you're right. This is the time of year you need to get the carpets cleaned, the windows cleaned, get everything ready for the holidays. Well, that sun is about down now.
It is. It's getting a little nippier by the minute. There's a great shot of our judges' stand. We can't do the parade without them either.
And I think they've got the toughest job.
Yeah.
They really do.
They've got a lot of good competition today.
Our next entry is the Special Olympics of Cabarrus County. The mission of Special Olympics is to provide year-round sports training and athletic competitions in a variety of Olympic-type sports for children and adults with disabilities. Established in 1968, the Special Olympics have become a worldwide event. As you can tell from their float, they've got the world there represented. The 2011 World Summer Games was in Athens, Greece. Wow, South Korea will host the 2013 World Winter Games. Thank you for being with us today. Merry Christmas.
Congratulations to all our athletes. Congratulations.
Appreciate all that you do.
And we have some more beautiful queens coming down. This is Emily Miner, Miss Gastonia's outstanding teen. She's the 14-year-old daughter of Joe and Carrie Miner of Concord. She's an honor student at Cox Mill High School, and she looks forward to promoting her platform entitled Beautifully Different, Building Confidence While Overcoming Insecurities. What a great, great platform. And to be 14 years old, is she not the most poised young lady you have seen?
That is amazing.
She's
beautiful. You can see why she's an outstanding teen.
And she'll be competing at the Miss North Carolina Outstanding Teen Pageant in June. Lovely young lady.
Beautiful. I can see more coats and jackets coming on out here.
Yeah, I think everybody's bundling up just a little bit more than they were earlier.
Yes, next we have got Punchy Whitaker's Wheel and Tire, family owned and operated since 1965 by Punchy Whitaker. Great decorated truck. Oh, look at the tires, like a Christmas tree. That's fantastic. That looks good. Handles all your vehicle needs from routine car maintenance to wheels and tires to car accessories. I love the way they've done the tires to make a Christmas tree.
Well, that just shows you all the different sizes that tires come in, too, from the great big Mack truck tires to these little ones that...
That's a good point. That's
sometimes
good point.
They put the little tires on the big cars. That's weird.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. It's just strange. And they're like an inch above the road, and you're afraid they're going to get scraped. But anyway, to each his own.
Yeah, it shows what I know about tires. That's for sure.
But we are having a great afternoon. I think the crowd might be thinning from some little ones just a little bit. But we've had a great turnout today for our 84th annual Concord Christmas Parade.
Hopefully when people watch this on TV, they'll be able to see that light through the trees, because it is absolutely beautiful right now coming through here. Seems like in the past years all the leaves were down, but I don't know.
It may be because we were a little drier this fall. They didn't drop as quick. Again, Crown Productions, they got some great shots of the parade, and up Union Street here is just beautiful. This entry is from Wyolina. I think I said that right. Wyolina Kennels. It's a one-stop pet service. They do boarding, daycare, grooming, and training. And you can bring your pet in for Christmas. Our pets need care, too, during Christmas. They need gifts. They need a bath or a manicure. And they even have an in-ground swimming pool so that you can give your pet a vacation. And that's great exercise for older dogs. So
may not be a bad idea for me to go to this place. It sounds really nice. I don't know. We have another spa coming up. Maybe this one will be more, better than me going to the dog spa. SNOB Salon and Spa is located at 509 Union Cemetery Road. a unique boutique style environment. And don't they look fantastic? Merry Christmas!
Oh, I love the fuzzy boots.
They look like a fun group. Styles not outrageous, but spectacular. That's what the snob stands for. Styles not outrageous, but spectacular.
Love that.
That's a great name.
And we have Cabarrus Vocational Group. They provide job skills and life skills training for the intellectually disabled adults in Cabarrus County. Now, they have a 12,000 square foot facility that they provide work and education training so that their consumers can earn a paycheck. They improve the quality of life for these individuals who help work with them. So,
Merry Christmas. Thanks for coming today.
Merry Christmas.
This is the RCC Student Life. Each participant represents the 20 student organizations on the campus of Rowan Cabarrus Community College. The students wish the residents of Rowan and Cabarrus County a happy holiday as the college begins its 50th anniversary celebration in 2013.
Well, these last couple of years have definitely been milestones with the Boys Club. CMC's their 75th, Girl Scouts 100th, and then RCCC will have their 50th next year. And this is their cosmetology club. It's one of the largest and best cosmetology programs in the state of North Carolina. They have centers located at Cloverleaf Plaza and Main Street in Salisbury, and over 200 students are training right now to become the leading cosmetologist and manicurist in the region.
Oh, look at the gingerbread man.
They've created Candyland with brightly colored Happy Kingdom filled with sugar-coated gumdrops, gingerbread houses, lollipops, and some favorite candy treats.
That was great.
Yeah.
Rowan County Tourism Development Authority. The Scrooge Holiday Trolley Tour presented by Lee Street Theater Group. Our trolley ride through historic downtown Salisbury while actors act out scenes from Dickens' The Christmas Carol. Now that's something different. I like that. It will run every Friday and Saturday evening beginning November 23rd, which will be the day after Thanksgiving, and ending December 22nd. That sounds like a fun thing to do.
And we have the young ladies from Charlotte Cocker Rescue of North Carolina, and they're based out of Kannapolis. They save homeless Cocker Spaniels from North Carolina shelters. They're all fully vetted, altered, and placed up for adoption. Some beautiful animals there. They've got Carter, Chesney, Kenny. Kenny Chesney, I can't get it out. And maybe two more will be coming along. And they do have one little three-legged blonde Cocker. Aww. So they need some forever homes, as our friend Larry would say.
They are so cute. Our next vehicle is a Cabarrus Emergency Medical from Cabarrus Emergency Medical Service. Once again, one of the things that we are constantly in need of and that help our society so much when we are in need. So
absolutely. We have Cabarrus Dance Academy. They're the oldest operating dance studio in Cabarrus County, and they were formerly known as Peggy Lee School of Dance. We all at one time or another went to Peggy Lee School of Dance. We loved Peggy Lee. The school opened the 67th season this fall, and they've got a float that characters from their Christmas ballet are riding on, and the Christmas ballet is for the benefit of the Coltrane Life Center. So this year's performance is December 15th, and they've had their ballet benefit for 25 years now. beautiful young ladies.
Next, we have Quality Custom Distribution. That's hard for me to get out. 2010 Peterbilt tractor, 53-foot trailer, driven by Jonathan Bone. This vehicle represents Quality Custom Distribution at the Special Olympics convoy in September at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Quality Custom Distribution is a full-service company, food service company out of Pineville, North Carolina.
Now, Teresa, this was one of our newer entries this year. This is Riley's Wagons of Love. No, of Wove. I have to say that right. This is in honor of children with epilepsy. Riley's Wagons of Wove was started by in honor of Riley Brown. And for the past 6 years, he's battled severe epilepsy, sometimes up to 100 seizures a day. So his family wanted to help other people in their situation, so their goal is to provide patients with some awesome little wagons, and they are cute as they can be. If someone sees a wagon waiting for them there, maybe it'll help them feel better.
That's great. That's another wonderful organization. Our next float is from the Shiloh United Methodist Church, the little church with the big heart. And they're located on Odell School Road. And they sound like they have some big hearts. Merry Christmas.
They have some little ones there. And we have Gamma Epsilon Zeta Chapter of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, and this is their debutante queen. And she is Kristen. I'm sorry, I can't read the last name there.
It might have been McClamrock or something similar.
Okay. But we're glad to have her, and she's absolutely beautiful.
This is the J.M. Robinson Air Force Junior Officer Reserve Training Corps, representing J.M. Robinson High School, and it's in its sixth year. And once again, this looks like an awfully large group, a highly decorated unit. They entered in 2006. They entered the Distinguished Unit Award. They've won all kind of awards that are listed here. The unit has 70 to 80 cadets each semester. That is a lot of young men and women.
And Teresa, I'm not absolutely positive. I think this is correct, that each of these groups that have gone by are different flights. I think that's what they call them. Whether they're by age or rank or what, I'm not sure, but I believe they do call them ranks for the different groups. And we have Miss J.M. Robinson High School, Karina Hutula. She was crowned in 2012 and will compete in the larger Carousel Scholars Competition in Charlotte. And she's planning on going to Virginia Tech next fall.
Great. We have the J.M. Robinson Homecoming King and Queen, Jason, Andrea,
Underjack,
okay.
And Michaela.
And Michaela Shaw. Welcome.
And J.M. Robinson Band has won over 25 first or second place awards, so let's take a listen to their Christmas renditions.
Thank you.
outstanding.
They just sounded wonderful. And, you know, with flag girls, it's amazing to me with that big old flag and they're walking down the street how graceful and poised they are. They're the J.M. Robinson cheerleaders and support group. Band cannot function without somebody in a gator.
That is true.
It is. These band boosters, the moms and dads, they are great. Absolutely great.
You know, I'm not sure the bands could function without the parents because they do a lot. I believe we have the 4-H Club and Diamond B Saddle Club. I think I hit that one right.
That's exactly right.
They are a group of children 6 to 16 years old dedicating to help our community, country, and the world. Our two-legged friends, they help with our two-legged friends, Meals on Wheels in Cabarrus County, the four-legged friends, and causes of the horses at the Horse Protection Society in China Grove. So we welcome them, and they certainly seem happy to be here.
And we have the members of the Historic Cabarrus Association cruising along in this replica of a 1920s Model A from the Concord Telephone Company truck. Historic Cabarrus Association sponsors the Concord Museum and the Cabarrus County Veterans Museum, both located downtown. In 2013, Historic Cabarrus will celebrate its 40th anniversary.
Here we go, another one. Dance Dreams. Dance Dreams is located in Kannapolis and is under the direction of Glenna Wilson. This will be the studio's, here we go, Karen Suzanne, 36th year of offering all types of dance to all ages.
But they're only 25.
Yes.
Yeah, their instructors are all 25, so...
Glenna also travels with two major dance workshops across the United States.
And we have our Concord Alumni Chapter Delta Sigma Theta Sorority. And in this first car was Miss Anisha Howie, Miss Jabberwock, and Miss Carrie McKenzie, Miss Junior Jabberwock, and our third young lady is Miss Sierra Johnson, Miss Teen Jabberwock. Now, the Jabberwock, you remember it from Alice in Wonderland, I think, but it's an evening of elegance for young ladies, and it's filled with entertainment that showcases the gifts and talents of each of these young women. So it's a great objective of the Delta Sigma Theta Scholarship Program.
And they are beautiful. Dance Fusion, located in Harrisburg, will present the Nutcracker Ballet on December the 8th at 2 and 7 at J.N. Robinson High School. Don't they look wonderful? For further information, you can contact Dance Fusion directly. Certainly happy to have them here with us today. I'm sure some of these girls might be getting a little cool in some of those dresses.
Well, we have Northeast Ear, Nose, and Throat Center of Kannapolis. Welcome this year. They provide a full range of ear, nose, and throat medical services, including surgery and hearing aid services and skincare with cosmetics, with much, much more. So their friends and family and neighbors want to wish us all a warm hello and a Merry Christmas.
Zen for Life Massage Therapy is promoting a grand opening in downtown Concord with Melissa Fassett and Linda Sartell, NST practitioner. The limousine will be our chariot, and it certainly was. So that's Zen for Life Massage Therapy. And I kind of get the impression it has just opening or have not had their opening yet.
Just in time for the holidays, I think. Teresa, these are some of the employees and their family and friends from Walmart. Now, the Walmart out on 29 was the very first super center in this area. So, they were the original super center. And so we're so glad to have y'all with us today. Great, great bunch of people.
And we have Lanier Law Group, personal injury attorneys with offices statewide. If you've been injured, hire a heavyweight. Call Lanier Law Group. You can find them at 1-888-CONSULT. Well, Suzanne, I wonder if we're getting sort of close to seeing the big man.
Well, you know, we've got our little cards that we read copy off of, and that stack has gotten down to not that many left. But this is the old Courthouse Youth Theater. Represents our community theater's future, and it will be a Christmas theme of dream sequence, incorporate popular Christmas characters and songs of the holidays, like Dreaming of a White Christmas.
Oh, they're great.
They are. They're super.
Well, I think we have Concord High School beginning. The first one is the Concord High School Health Occupation Students of America, and they are loud.
Well, they might still be excited after last
That's night's win.
Game.
Go Spiders!
Go Spiders!
Yeah, what a win last night. Yeah.
Now, we have their homecoming court, Ugoji Nwangi, Nakia Black. We have Destiny Floyd, Lucy Sudreth, and Shakira Roberts. And Ryan Macon is their homecoming king, so...
Hey, Sudreth!
Welcome, everyone. Now, Concord won last night in overtime, I think. So, are they going to the playoffs?
I'm not sure if they play next.
Or is there another game?
There's two more games. And I'm not sure if next week they play the next game or not.
Okay.
But I hope I've got that right.
Well, we're awfully proud of them. And beside...
And I believe
one more game? Two more games.
Two more games. And there come the homecoming king and queen. There
yes,
you go.
That's Ryan and Shakira. Glad to have y'all. And that's Concord High Gold.
All right.
Gold and
sure
black.
That sure is.
Now, this is a little different entry for Concord High this year. And it's because we have done so well in their football. So we actually have a football team. And we actually had the bell.
Oh, great.
The bell is back where it belongs, y'all.
Way. That's an exciting.
That is an exciting team. Congratulations, guys.
Go Spiders!
Go Concord. Go Concord.
Congratulations! Woo!
Thanks for bringing that bell home.
I'm sure these cheerleaders are tired.
Cheerleaders. Of course, you know, Teresa, Concord High, of course, is the home band. And as the home band, they're the last band in the parade. But that also means that they are welcoming a special guest. So we'll take a listen to Concord High. Thank you.
support group. Look, yep. The band couldn't do without. Thank you for all you do.
Like we said earlier, you can't have a band and not have a gator or a golf cart. Now, this is the lovely ladies from Salon 419, and they have a team of mini mules that are pulling them along from Get Right Ranch in Romertown. The stylists specialize in color and hair cutting, and so be sure to go online to salon419.com, make an appointment. You'll be all beautiful for when the next guy comes along. Who is it, kids?
Who's next?
You're right, it's Santa Claus. Oh, and Rudolph's even up there. Does everybody see Rudolph?
Merry Christmas, Santa. Merry Christmas. Come see me.
I'll leave you better cookies than she will.
Merry Christmas.
We've got a long list.
Merry Christmas. What a perfect parade.
Absolutely perfect. And, of course, our last entry is Cabarrus County EMS. And here comes the parade director and
Big Daddy.
Yeah.
Big Daddy Howard.
Big Daddy is,
we need to thank
bringing
him
up the rear
for all the work he does to direct this parade for us and bring it to us every year. Thank you, Johnny.
And he's got some of our great volunteers riding with him. We cannot do this parade without volunteering. So if you're ever interested, there's Miss Janet. Go online to www.cabarrusevents.org. This is not the only event we do, so check us out. And again, thank everyone for coming. We had a great crowd.
It was fun.
And it's still light out, so we did get a little shorter parade this year. Still cold. Thank ACN and the City of Concord and all our wonderful volunteers, CMC Northeast, and congratulations on their 75th anniversary this year. Crown Productions could not do this without you.
Couldn't.
We love you guys. And, of course, Channel 22, you'll be able to see the parade probably later on next week. We hope everyone has a great, happy holiday.
Isn't that true? Happy Thanksgiving and happy holidays.
Thank you.
band.